And I guess, I mean, it doesn't matter if I show this or not, I don't think. Wait, actually, what would, let me just double check that this other one looks okay with, like, yeah, looks good, I think. Okay. I just wanted to make sure that they looked like they were, like, the same art set, or, like, they looked like they were getting the same, like, whoops, that's not, I did not mean to hide those things, I meant to hide these things. Just made, wanted to make sure that they looked like they were getting the same art treatment. Okay. So now layer, yeah, so now layer 19 and 3. What on earth was I gonna say? I swear, I was gonna say something else music related. Something else about music that. Oh, yeah. Okay. So. Yeah. There are some platforms on which you cannot actually not listen to music and watch Twitch at the same time. And in my opinion, that's something for those platforms to fix. Because they're the minority of platforms. It's a popular platform. Like, there are popular platforms on which you can't do that. But it's. But like in if you put together a list of the platforms you can do that and the platforms you can't do that, the platforms you can't do that are actually very few. Some like I said, some of them are popular, but in my opinion, it's theirs to f it's that's their that's that theirs to fix. And so yeah, like I said before, like about the silent parts of my stream, there aren't silent parts of my stream. The quietest my stream ever gets is when I'm making like beep boop bloop 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 bling blong. Like that's like those. The reason I make those noises, not like intentionally, but like subconsciously, the reason I'm making those noises is because I don't have I don't, there like there isn't downtime on my stream. Like I view audio only as a valid form of like dev stream engagement. Like if people are literally only listening to the audio, that's I think like I. It's not just that I think that's okay, it's that I anticipate that such that I like accommodate that as like a valid mode of engagement. So like yeah, right. So like I don't know. I hypothetically like people could be on those platforms where they can't listen to music and all consoles pff, are all consoles that dumb? Are like all consoles that turbo dumb? 'Cause like, yikes! If so, I mean, I'm not saying it's not the case. I'm just saying if that's the case, like, they have like serious issues. Like, there's, it's just like, whoever made those systems were like arbitrarily good or arbitrarily bad. Let's go with arbitrarily bad. I mean, I know there's a little more involved than like that, but like, not much more. Not when you compare it to like what they're actually considering. Like, yeah, it's the sort of thing like, maybe that like. I don't know. The platforms that have it probably don't have it for free. Like someone had to intentionally like put that in there. But the platforms that don't have it, like their exclusion of that, like so unimpressive to me. Like I honestly I hope those platforms just like die out. I hope they just like disappear because they do a disservice to like the medium as a whole. Like again, I'd be equal like I'm not I don't have anything against those platforms and like I'd be equally happy that they just like they just like wake up and you know get with the program and like stop sucking. Not to imply that they suck, but in this particular regard, and then like yeah, as a secondary thing, like if they just like stop existing altogether, that'd be fine. Because if they just stopped existing altogether, then people would use other means to to people would just use better platforms instead. Oh, that's gross. I didn't even realize like all consoles are that way. Like seriously? Ugh. Dirty, 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 dirty. That's like I don't know. I really hope they're just I really hope it's just an oversight. I really hope it's the sort of thing that like they just never thought of that and as soon as they realize that, they like I said, like that they fix it or like I mean, it's not literally a fix. Like, it's not literally a bug that you can't do that, but like, that they like compensate, I guess, for yeah. What I don't know. All right, I guess I just have to pray that like the side of reason wins out, because like everything we've talked about so far, like it's not like those other things that we've talked about are going to get fixed. It's not like people are going to, it's not like someone's going to invent a form of music that everyone all agrees is great and that everyone can listen to all at the same time while agreeing that it's great and that they want to listen to it all at the same time. No, people are always going to have different opinions on whether they like music or not. Like, that's always going to be the case. So, like, that's not going to change. I mean, like, the closest thing, like, so, like, the best thing that I've seen that, like, kind of accomplishes, like, essentially, like, not even just, like, not even just the things that I like about streaming, but, like, basically, like, everything I've heard expressed about as, like, desirable is, like, I guess, like, some channels will have, like, a companion music source. Like, what was the one that Protospasm mentioned earlier? Like, Protospasm said, I forget what it was. It was like Soma FM. I don't know what that one is, but like hypothetically, like if like yeah, like if there was like an official like music source for this stream, like that would be cool, right? Because then people could who wanted to like listen to like the official like soundtrack of like the stream could like listen in that way, and then other people who wanted to like listen to their own thing instead could as well. So like I guess like the only thing that like we really would be that I would like necessarily consider like an improvement is like if there was like some integration of that. So like wouldn't it be great if there was like a if there was like instead on Twitch there was like two volume dials, like a music volume dial and like a rest of the audio volume dial, so that way streams could have music as like an optional thing, and then you could like, but then if you didn't want it you could turn it down. Like that's the only thing that I would like, but like again, like I don't even see that as necessary because like apart from those few platforms where like apparently like someone made a terrible decision once upon a time in my opinion. Like I don't even really see a need for that per se, but so that's yeah, I don't know. So that's I think that's probably about as much mileage as I can get out of the question of why don't I have music? I probably drained that well, pretty well. But am I also now done with the? I think I might also. Yeah, I think I'm also done with the legs now. I think I am now 100% legged up. So I can get rid of well, I don't really have to get rid of those swatches, but I should at some point. So yeah, so for each of these legs, well yeah, I'll just export them and then we can find out if I missed anything. Do 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 do. So we can show these as well. Oh yeah, leg zero is the only one that I'll have to split out when I ex when I'm not when I export, but when I'm working on the next thing, which is putting the wraps on a different set of legs. Okay, so first things first, let's take extents. I don't anticipate extents will change, so we can probably even reuse the same data file. Right, because all of the changes were like internal. They were not like they're like it was just changing like the ankle re region. It was not actually changing like the external outside region. So yeah, so 61, 61, 50, 21, which I think was the same here. Yeah, so I'm just gonna copy this data file, and then what are these? These are leg wraps, I think. Yeah, leg wraps is the name of this one. So new folder leg wraps. Leg wraps art test, and then paste the data file here, and then yeah, so I want to squish and unsquish these layers as I export them. So let's squish these layers. Copy. Oh, oops, no, I do want to do zero first. So copy. New. Okay. Paste. Save. Let's save it to the correct folder, which is equipment. Legs. Leg wraps art test. Yeah, I did spell that correctly. It looked like at test or something. Okay. Excuse me. excuse me. Okay. So this is zero. Okay, save that. And then sorry, so this is Zero A, copy, undo the squishing, new file, paste, save as zero A. I don't know what that dong was about, but whatever. Layers, so what now? Layers 16 and legs 1. Squish, copy, undo, new, okay, paste, save. This is 1. And then layer 17, squish, copy, undo, new, okay, paste, save. This is 1A. And everything's looking good so far. Yeah, so far so good. And then, okay, so layer 18, squish, copy, undo, new, okay, paste, save. This one is 2. Okay. 19, squish, copy, new, okay, paste. Oops, I forgot to undo. Save. 2A. So, undo, squish. Wait, that was 3? Oh, did I miss one? I think I did, I think I did 3 as 2A. Layer 18, copy, undo, new, okay, paste, save. Yeah, this one is, this one that I called 2A is actually 3. Whoops. And this one is 2A, yeah. Okay. And then, lastly, layer 20, squish, copy, undo, new, okay, paste, save. And this one is 3A. Yes. So, how many mods does my stream have? I don't know. How many cool people have I met? That's the those questions have the same answers. By the way, why do you create pixel art with double A on? I don't. I guess is why. Although you like the way you describe it is not like wrong. I'm not doing pixel art. I'm just doing very small art. It's not pixel art. I don't, like, you'll notice I don't draw pixel by pixel. I just draw very small art. And so, as a result, you can see the pixels. But it's not like, I mean, like, look at in screen, like, down there. It's not like anything looks pixelated. Like, there's no pixelization. It's not pixel art. It's just small art. if you're asking me like why I don't intentionally alias things, it's like because aliasing looks bad. I don't know. Like, I mean, I guess you could use aliasing stylistically if you wanted to like have that as like a look. But I think in general, people like the reason AA exists as a term is that people like it. People are generally opposed to aliasing. So, like, I mean, if I wanted to, I could make, like, all the lines, like, jagged and atrocious if I wanted to. And, yeah, why don't I do that, I guess? your guess is as good as mine. Probably, because you'd also come up with the correct answer if you were to guess at that. let's just make sure that the leg wraps look okay now, I guess. I undid all the squishing. Good. Okay. Let's replace linen pants art test with which were these? These were leg wraps. Leg wraps art test. Replace all. Save that. And so now PyCharm. Yes, you can. It's right there. See it? See the game? There's the game. I was also about to run the version of the game that we're working on, like the one with the increased frame rate. So yeah, so that's the game as it's running now. And then so if you're wondering like why are we working on legs all day today? It's because we're converting it to what we see up here. So you'll notice like the only difference is that the animation just is it there's twice as much of it. Like every time the bottom screen clicks once, the top screen clicks twice. So yeah, I just decided it was time. It was just time to see. I'm never gonna play this game, Jordan Swag. I mean, that's not true. I do sometimes play this game, but you play this game. You play this game. Like, you're literally playing this game right now. Whether you realize it or not, you're literally playing this game right now. So, yeah. let me know if you have more requests, though. I'm happy to oblige. The only reason I can't oblige that request, right, like, more so than I'm already obliging it, is because I'm already obliging it. all right, so yeah, I think this animation looks fine. Yeah, sure. And then all right, so stop that, and then yeah, right. So the reason for most of these layers I did the leg wrap separately is that if I recall correctly, the next upgrade is what? We're getting pretty close, you guys. We're getting there. I didn't want to sound too overly optimistic earlier because I knew we had a long way to go. But look at this. We just did leg wraps and this is the end of the document. Like this is like so I think we do still have like two or three more upgrades to do, but we're getting there. We might have four more upgrades to do. Let's find out. All right, so we just did leg wraps. The next one, not farmer shirt, so farmer pants. Farmer pants I think are basically just like a pants swap of the so like we're like so this was the reason we were doing it out of separate layers, right? And so what we can do now is we can just take the well let's look. I'm pretty sure okay, so shoe buckle is gonna be the silliest little change. So shoe buckle and farmer pants are two leg upgrades, but farmer pants is just swapping out the yellow pants with black pants, basically. And then shoe buckle is literally just putting a buckle on the shoe that we already have. And then after that so that's everything for the farmer look. And then I forget if there's I think there are two upgrades. Yes, there are two upgrades for the there are at least two upgrades for the next one as well. So, yeah, so shoulder armor, purple sleeves, pointed helmet, no back, chest plate. So tall boots is like a thing. So that we'll do that at some point. And then leg armor is also a thing. I mean, leg armor is an addition to the tall boots. So for leg armor, we basically just take the tall boots. Once we've made the tall boots, we just take the tall boots and put leg armor onto them. And so that it'll there'll be a little bit to do there, but it's, you know, it's not going to be that dire. We could finish this today, feasibly. So, cool. I mean, I did like, yeah. I don't know. What's the point of the game development? Are you joking, Jordan? Like, if you can't figure that out, like, I'm not going to tell you. You need to figure that out on your own. You need to figure that out. Like, if you're asking it as a rhetorical question to yourself to like guide your understanding, like, then good. Like, I wish you luck on your way. The question for anyone who hadn't glanced at chat is, why is this stream game development? Like, why is this stream under game development? Like, what about this stream could possibly be game development related? What might have occurred at some point on this stream that is somehow in any way involved or related to game development? I'm gonna write down the answer. Here, wait. Don't look at the screen, Jordan. I'm gonna write down the answer. In a notepad document real quick, when you guess the correct answer, we can show you the answer and it'll be correct. So don't look at the screen. So what in this stream is game development related? Okay, wait. Don't look at. Okay, now you can look. So we have the answer written down. And so yeah. Whenever you have a guess, feel free to guess, and we can compare it to the answer that we've written down, and we can see if you're correct. All right. Sorry. Questions like that are like just very special to me. It's important for me to take the time to answer this. Thanks. All right, let's so what did we just do? We just did leg wraps, right? Yeah, look at us. Look how far we've gotten. So yeah, so farmer pants. I think farmer pants are basically just black pants again. Black pants, but with the leg wraps. that is a fantastic emote. The what is it? Shocks troll. thank you, Yakimus. Edvinus, congratulations. Congratulations, Edvinus. You got it. You got it right. okay, yeah. So, wait, what am I doing here? Oh, yeah. I was gonna look up the what did I call them? Farmer pants. Sorry. Sorry. farmer pants. Yeah, the farmer pants were just a swap of the yellow pants for black pants. We literally don't even change the shoe or anything. It's literally just it's the swap out, and I think these are probably the same as the black pants. So we probably literally have all the pieces that we need. We just have to like stack them together, right? So I will, since we're not drawing this this color the colors of this of the leg armor anymore. We're done drawing it. We don't have to draw any additional. Like we just use the stuff that we have already. We can get rid of this. This is on what? This is on the face layer. I think I put this. Oh, and there's apparently a dot on some other layer, but I won't worry about that right now. Yeah, whatever. That's fine. I'll just ignore it for now. I must have just like accidentally like dapped the stream, the screen when I was color picking from it. Okay, so yeah, legs layer zero. This is the exception because okay, actually, you know what I'm gonna do first? I'm gonna before I do the other part with the black pants, I'm gonna reduce the number of layers that we have here because like it's just like a little cluttersome right now. So I'm gonna start by just like, oops, those ones I meant to keep. What the heck? I've like. Oh, it must be on leg zero. This is unclicking layers. I was like waiting for that little pixel to disappear, but it was the one that I hadn't unclicked. All right, I lied. I did actually want to get rid of it, but no, I did also want to do this other stuff as well. So, all right, yeah. Basically, like my first task is basically just get rid of the yellow, and like this is the layer that I forgot to separate them out, so this one I'll just do like manually. Do 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 Excuse me. Okay, yeah. So then the rest of the layers, the rest of them will be easier because there's still like a little bit of yellowish like lingering here. Do do do. Do 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 do. sorry, I'm just distracted. I'll be honest. Earlier today, I accidentally yanked out my headphones that's not the whole story. There's more to it. How did I start? Did I say, I'll be honest? Earlier today, I yanked out my headphones, and when I did that, I try not to check my mobile device during the stream because I don't like get distracted by like social media and like notifications and stuff like that. But when I went to put my when I plugged my headphones back in and went to turn the music back on, I saw a notification on my screen. I only saw the first half of it, and I'm a little bit just I'm not like literally distracted by it, but like it's been like on my mind. Like I haven't forgot about it, and I'll be really interested later after the stream to find out like what that notification says because like I read half of it. And like, at first, like I was like, "What? That's crazy. What does that even mean? Like, why? What?" But then at a certain point, it like dawned on me like what it could mean. And so, I don't know. It's really funny now because it could. I know. I just like I don't know, and I just like so. It's my mind is just running wild with it, and I just like I don't know why I felt like I had to share that, but like it's just I don't know. I guess because it's like it keeps coming to mind, and usually like I try and be like forthright about what is my like train of thought, and so I guess like yeah. So I guess the reason I felt compelled to mention it is just because if you've noticed that my train of thought occasionally like veers into like. A momentary lapse. It's yeah, that's because like hey Jesse Freeman. Thank you very much for hosting. Everyone, welcome to the channel. Hey. We're working on what we have going on here for people who haven't seen it before. We have so Side Quest is the name of the game. It's what's playing along the bottom of the screen now. What we're working on is actually a slight visual update to it. If you've never played it before, the short version of the explanation is it's kind of like Dungeons and Dragons played through Twitch a little bit. Yeah, right. So one of the big questions I've been getting throughout the entire project is like, what's with the frame rate? And my answer has been I'm not an animator, and so I can't make the frame rate look good. What I'm doing now, though, is I guess like the best that I can. I realized at a certain point, like just this week, that like I can't do great animation, but I can do at least one step better than this. So what we're converting the project to look like instead is like what we have up here. You can kind of see like on this version, there's just a little bit more animation. Like the characters are just like, you know, it's literally in like this one runs at 2 frames per second, and this one runs at 4 frames per second. So it's like, you know, that's technically an upgrade, right? Yeah, we're going back and we're updating a bunch of the character art because the character art was all drawn at 2 frames. Fredo's Maza! I don't know why that was kind of soft, but that was the donation noise. Thank you very much, Fredo's Maza. Thank you very much for your generosity. Protoplasm donated $2.02 and says, Protoplasm donates $2.02 and says, read your bleep notification because curiosity will kill me. All right, well, heck, I will oblige your quest. All right, we will resume the so just a second ago I was talking about on stream how I don't usually like check my messages like on social media or anything like during a stream, but I accidentally caught a peek of one earlier and it's been like weighing on my mind. So all right, so Protospasm is curious to know what it says, and let me find out. I went to check it on my mobile device, but it sorry, it came through Facebook, and I just remembered that like Facebook did the whole like they like moved their messages to a separate app or something. I don't understand what that was about. Like I don't, maybe it made sense to someone over there at like where they are, but like to me, I don't understand what it's about. Oh, okay. Whoa, yeah, okay, hold on. Oh my gosh, okay. No, it actually was like what I was it actually was what I thought, which is funny. Okay, so the thing that so okay, I just read the message real quick. Because it was personal correspondence, I didn't want to show it or read it on stream. But I'll get back to work and we can talk about what it was. And so the short answer is I was correct, and it is as hilarious as I expected it to be. okay, yeah, what we were working on before I got distracted was I think we're almost done with it. Yeah, so like as we saw in like the little animation preview that we just looked at a moment ago, like the characters were like. That were running across the screen. They had like these yellow pants that they Like they had these yellow pants with these like leg wrap pieces on them. And so the way the character progression works in this game, you like you get like new equipment like in an incremental fashion. So we added in those leg wraps. But the next character upgrade actually like changes the sorry, protospasm. I will get back to the topic in a second. I don't want to leave the game leave the stream entirely devoid of game development. Oops, wrong layer. Okay, so yeah, so what we're doing is we're like using the same pieces, but we're swapping out the yellow for the new pant color will be black. So we're gonna add that in as well. Okay, so so one of the common questions I get on the stream, I am addressing the topic now, protoplasm. One of the frequent questions I get on the stream, or just in general, is like, what games have I worked on? Like specifically, like when I worked in AAA, like what games did I work on? And I worked in AAA for 6 years, but I was actually at the same company for all 6 years, and yeah, I had a pretty good run there because it was a good place to work, and like I was having fun, and they were paying me money. Which is always nice. Money's nice. It helps with stuff. Yeah, I worked at this one place, which was it was yeah, like I said, it was a fine place to work. I'm doing like my I'm like working more independently lately, and I'm not missing the old situation. But that's not to say it wasn't fine while I was there. Because it was. It was like I said, it was a fun place to work. The message that I got was, oh yeah. Okay, so when I started, so right, there's more backstory. when I started working there, not long after I started working there, someone else started working there, who I did not know was like applying, but I had known from like a completely other context, like not a complete, not a professional context at all. It was like a friend of a friend that I had met like years prior, like 5 years prior or something like that. But like someone I had known who had like you know, who like I like we weren't like the closest, but like we knew each other, right? We at least knew who the other was. Yeah, so it was funny because like at a certain point, like I was working there, I was like, I know that person, and So I just got a message. I just got so like I said earlier, so earlier in the stream I accidentally ripped out my earbuds, and so in order to get my music playing again, I had to plug my earbuds back in and then hit the play button again because it automatically mutes when the earbuds get ripped out. When I did that, I saw my notification screen and it gave me like a teaser of like this notification that I got. The message that I got was from a friend whom I haven't at this point whom I haven't seen in like 11 years really it's been a long time because like I said I worked at this place for like 6 years or so and it was like 5 years before that then I'd like known like this person from this other context so this is like a long time ago I get a notification from this person saying hey our mutual friend is looking for programmers at their company. And of course, the mutual friend was this person I mentioned that that I had gotten a job at the same company I had been working for. Of course, the company in question is the company that I've been working for the past 6 years. So it's not like it's not that funny, but it it was just enough that like, well, so okay, so what happened? Yeah, the reason I personally found it so funny is that like, when I saw the message, I didn't see the whole thing, right? It was just the little preview that you get on the notification screen. So we got the preview at the notification screen, and it was this person that I hadn't seen for a long time, and all I saw of the message was, it didn't say the person's name. It didn't say it was of course like I knew the name of the person who wrote me the message, but the person who wrote the message did not specify like which mutual friend exactly. And so like the first thing I read was like you know like mutual friend And then something about programmers, and that's like all I that's all I like got out of it. It was like mutual friend programmers, and then so I was like, so at first I was like, I don't know what that's about. Like, what? Why do I care about? Like, why are you telling me about programmers? And like that was like all that went through my mind. But then like over the course of the next like several hours, like it was just like in the back of my mind, like I don't know, just because like I knew that little piece of information, like like there's like you know like a background process of my brain was like you know devoting like a minor amount of effort in or in like towards deciphering it, and yeah, so eventually it was like eventually it clicked in my mind, like I bet I know what that message is about, and so yeah, so we checked and yeah. I don't know what happened in chat, but thank you to whoever is on top of the moderation business. So, oh yeah. Oh, thank you, Legendary Neurotoxin. Yeah, some people like just show up and like post links to like write like what like you know just like anything that involves you giving them money, and it's like I don't, it's like. I, it's not that I don't wish them well per se. It's just that like they we don't really need that here. So yeah, thank you for filtering that out. All right, so yeah, okay, so we rinsed out as I was like blah, 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 telling that not so hilarious tale. I cleaned up all the yellow the remnants of like the previous yellow of armor set. So. Now we have like we have lined up like another piece that's kind of gonna be the complementary set to what we have here. And if I recall correctly, it is Black Pants Art Test. Because this yeah, so basically where we'd had the yellow pants previously, we can kind of just like slot in these black pants and what is oh, it has sandals. Which is funny, but we can just get rid of the sandals, trim out the sandals. There might be some overlap because like the leg wraps are like kind of like tight, whereas these pants have like a slight looseness to them. So there might be some places where we have to shave that in to get it to like fit quite right. But yeah, for the most part, this should work. Okay, so so leg zero. Oh yeah, that's the other thing is like, oh right. I was gonna reduce the number of layers, and I can do that now because like. For, so leg zero is already like smushed together, but like for legs 15 and legs O, leg 0A, like these are now complementary. So I can now like go through and squish these together. So 16 and legs 1 are complementary. 17 and 1A are complementary. And then down here we have 18 and 2A, 19 and 3, and then 20 and 3A, and oh, and 14 and 2 also. And then, right, because I'm about to add in a bunch more layers, so I figured I might as well clean up the old ones first. Okay, so let's add in a new layer underneath this layer. Yeah, underneath this layer. Copy this. So the pixel coordinates are, of course, going to be 61, 61, as ever. And yeah, so this is actually probably even like fine as it is. But just to clean up like a few straight pixels here and there, I'm gonna go through and erase the rest of that, and then yeah, there we have it. So now yeah, so the rest of this will just be as simple as that. Right. So wait, I do have to keep this these layers stacked in the correct order, but I can smoosh them together too, right? Yeah. There's no reason I can't smoosh these together because the next time. Oh wait. Actually, let me check. The next time we, yeah, no, I think the next time we upgrade our legs, like we completely change like the whole thing. Like Tall Boots uses, I think, just like a completely different color of like pant. So like we don't, yeah. So, 'cause we, okay, so when we switch to Tall Boot, we're gonna have to start from scratch. So there's no point in like preserving any of the layers or like the separation of the layer data or anything like that here. We can just like smoosh this all together and go for it. Yeah, so right, 6-0 and layer 14, we can smoosh that together. And this is the new legs 0 layer. And then right, so let's hide that. Let's show this one. And then so this one corresponds with this one. And like before, we will add in a new layer underneath and put it down to 61 pixel coordinate 61, 61. And okay, this I guess just over time, like drawing and redrawing the limbs again and again and again, they got slightly like the pant leg doesn't like line up exactly necessarily how I would have expected it to, but this is fine because we just need it like yeah, like this basically. Like I said, the leg wrap is supposed to look a little bit cinched, like it's supposed to supposed to be like wrapped tight. So yeah. Let's do what then. Yeah, let's keep on keeping on. We can so we can squish these layers together and rename this one leg 0A, and we can hide that for now. And these will all be ready to export. Like we can do the exporting step all together once we have pieced the rest of this stuff together. So we can add in a new layer again, position 61, 61. Oh, there's like a smudgy pixel here. And I think we all know how I think we all know what to do with smudgy pixels. Eliminate, exterminate. So we got it out of that file, so it's going to be in this file as well. It's very subtle and doesn't really make a huge difference, but I just prefer them not to exist, so that's not too harsh. That's not too much to ask, is it? I'd just rather they just don't exist at all. Okay, so get rid of that and then save that. Oh, well, I guess I didn't have to save that, but it doesn't hurt to save it either. I don't think I've saved it in a while, so safety saving is not a bad idea. Safety save, friends. Safety save. And if you have version control, use version control every day. Every day. and yeah. Okay. So let's add in a new layer here. And wait, no, not here. Here. Okay. And then so this one corresponds to this layer. So we can slap this in. Slide it down to position 61, 61. Coolest hangout spot in the world. All that's like position 61, 61. That's where everyone goes. Everyone who's anyone goes to hang out and be legs. I don't know what I'm talking about exactly. Sometimes I don't let that stop me from talking. The whole knowing what I'm talking about thing. Entirely optional, in my opinion. All right, this is good. So let's save that, and then I can squish these together, squish these layers, and this is the new layers, legs 1A and legs 2. Sorry, I'm just trying to remember, like the tall boots. Oh yeah, no. I was gonna say like, is this the same tone as the white pants from earlier in the level thing? But it's not. We use a different tone for this. I might use those white legs as a base. Yeah, I think that's actually how I did it the first time. I used the white legs as a base, and I used like a sheet to like overlay to like kind of like twist the color slightly. 61, 61 is to side quest as bronze is to side. excuse me. Oh shoot. Wait. Oh no. Am I putting these legs in the wrong position? I just noticed that like the torso doesn't line up quite right. Are the legs supposed to be actually like at 60? What? Oh, the sandals. Oh man. Maybe that's. Oh, whoops. Oops. Hold on. I might be a stupid person. A slightly stupid person. That's, just a little stupid. Yeah, I forgot about this. With the sandals, like, I think it's actually pixel. No, it is. It's just. Okay. No, it's pixel position 61, 61. I was, like, freaking out for a second there. I was like, oh, is it 62, 61? But, like, no, that's 60. Oh wait, no, this is the original version. I bet if the Black Pants art test, I bet this is gonna be 60, 62, 61. Ah, 62. Okay, yeah. Okay, so that would explain. I thought I was just like noticing like a little bit of art drift, but then like yeah, no, then I looked at like the waistline and the waistline was like not lining up at all. Oof, I'm a dumb person. I apologize because like I have to go back and undo a few of those steps. Whoops. Okay. This is the last one, though. Once we fix this one, we are back on track. So, whoops. Ah, man. I should just make a rule that, like, they all have to start at 61-61. Just, like, even if, like, it doesn't make sense for them to start there. Even if it cuts off part of the image, then they still have to start there. You know what I think was throwing me off is that, like, this side actually lines up okay. It's, like, this side that, like, doesn't line up quite right. And, like, when I shift it over to, like, the correct position, then all of a sudden, like, this side doesn't line up quite as well. But I guess that's fine. Like, I don't super care. I might... I don't know. Like, I might use this as an opportunity to clean up the upper line of this. Because, like, I don't necessarily... Well, no, this isn't going to be visible. This is the part that, like, you don't even see because, like, the hands are covering it up. At least that's always been the case. The one thing I've been considering, though, is hand animation, though. And if I add in, like, some amount of hand animation, then this might become visible. So I might actually want to be cleaning this stuff up. And if I'm cleaning this stuff up here, then, like, why not, like, clean it up in, like, this version of the file as well? I won't worry too much. I won't worry about that too much right now, but, like, I don't know. It is something to think about. And, like, specifically here, like... Yeah, so the thing that threw me off before, like, I might want to fix that up, because, like, I don't know. Yeah, that's fine. That took, like, not much effort. Okay, and then, yeah, so now let's, squish these together. Alright, so this is legs, legs, 0, and, alright, well, at least we get the hang of it now. We know exactly what we're doing now. I can start closing these images, too. Because I'm so certain, I'm so sure that we will not be doing it correctly. Fool me once, shame on me, because I'm the one who fooled me. Yep, that's, I don't know what I'm talking about. Deselect, alright, so yeah, like before, yeah, okay, so I guess the good news is that, like, the slides now fit together a little bit better, right? Like, the slight offsetting that I was describing earlier is, like, no longer, like, a concern. So there's that. alright, so squish these together. And, legs, 0A. And then we can close this one, because we're done with that. So select all, copy. Legs, 1, new layer, paste, and, this one goes again, 62-61. 62-61 is the sequel to 61-61. I've now decided. Are you saving these protospasms? Are you keeping a log of these? Because I feel like these are important for humanity. I feel like this is a great service that you're providing, and that future generations should know about this. Oh, excuse me, sorry. Don't mind me while I laugh like a goon. All right, well. I'll have to start tracking them then. Oh, you know what? I'm keeping track of them. Because one thing that I realized that is happening now... Oh, I'm keeping track of all of the ones that that come through while the script is running. Because the funny thing... so I started keeping a log files of, like, the script when it runs. So that way if something crazy happens, we can, like, you know, go and figure out what the heck is happening. But then... So then the one thing that it occurred to me, though, is that, like, it actually picks up chat while... I'm gonna search for the term ox. Oh, it's gonna find fox. Musk ox. No, it found it. This is what I was hoping it would find. Binry, you're such a good friend. You're a beautiful, talented, brilliant, powerful musk ox. Thank you, ox. Yeah, alright, so future generations. So if the script is ever down, it won't pick things up, but As long as the script is running. Okay. Sorry. That was important to me. Okay, so this one's good now. The waistband. I really don't have to care about this stuff until I actually make it so that the arms move and that this stuff actually gets shown. Because, like, until the arms move, like, this is never going to get seen. So it really doesn't matter if this is, like, pixel perfect or if it looks slightly squonky. I don't... Man, I want to watch that show more. I still have a bunch of episodes that I haven't watched yet, because, I'm saving them. I'm definitely a hoarder when it comes to entertainment. If I'm running low on a program that I like if the rate at which I watch episodes of a show is like proportionally related to the number of episodes I have remaining. If I have tons of episodes, I'll just like burn through them. But then as I like approach the end, I'll like gradually like slow down to a crawl. And so when there are only a few episodes to watch, I'll like watch one per like year basically. legs. This is legs layer one. All right, and then so let's do legs layer 1A. Copy. So we can hide this layer. Show this layer. Show an additional layer, or add an additional layer underneath this layer, paste this onto that layer, slide this over to 6261, the second coolest place on the planet. Okay, and then go through and delete this, and then this also. Not that that matters. Alright, so safety saves. I don't know. I'm doing a lot of safety saving. I don't have a specific reason, except that I guess it's a habit. And my brain is melting. but other than those two things, I don't really have a reason. Alright, so save this. That looks like the pants are hiked up too high. I don't know. I think the natural waist of this character is like right between the two pixels. But there's no such thing as half pixels, so... and with good reason, so. Some people get worried about having too many mods. Like, I guess I understand that. Except, no, I don't. There's no problem with having too many mods. Having too many mods means there are too many people you respect. It means there are too many. It means there are too many people that you trust. Is that a bad thing? It can be a foible to be too trusting. But if you trust people, and nothing goes wrong, like if your trust is like good and valid, like I don't know. That's never bothered me. Like sometimes we have a green sword party, but like I don't. Green sword party, sure. So safety save, all the safety saves. So I can squish these layers together. This one can be the new legs 1A. So we can hide that. Legs 2. We can, now that my stylus is, like, missing a button because I ripped it off and threw it away. No, I didn't throw it away. I have, like, a new favorite way to hold it. And so now if I'm not holding it correctly, I have to spin it around. No, not really. Oh, smudgy pixels. Look at all these smudgy pixels. Oh, my gosh. My heart is breaking. All these smudgy pixels. not to be dramatic, but... I'm dying. I'm dying in real life right now, from all these smudgy pixels. Let's fix that here as well. So there were some here, right? It was like there's some there and there were some over here. I think that was where the smudgy pixels lived. They're so sneaky. They're sneaky, subtle, dirty pixels or smudgy pixels, and that's how they get you. They get you off guard. when you least expect it, smudgy pixels, bam, out of nowhere. Oh, you know what I need to do is I need to make sure that these are compatible with the upper layers. Not these ones in particular, but layers like layer 3 and 3A. I'll need to make sure are compatible. These ones I can squish together. And this is the new legs layer 2. And then let's I'll yeah. Go team. Okay. I was just about to divert, but Yakimus showed up with the save. I mean, personally, I'm surprised legendary neurotoxins distraction or diversion was not satisfactory, but I guess maybe the snakes had never seen the Big Lebowski before. They didn't get the reference. All right. Sorry. All right, so we can hide this now and show this layer and add in a new layer here, which will contain this image situated at 62, 61. Oh gosh, look at all these smudgy pixels. This is like Revenge of the Smudgy Pixels. Is this like, did I do something wrong? Like, did I offend the deities of the smudgy pixels? Sorry, that did not go well. I just like as soon as I lassoed around all the smudgy pixels, quote unquote all the smudgy pixels, I saw more smudgy pixels. So I tried to lasso around a second time, but it didn't really go as I had hoped. Okay. So yeah, where were the smudgy pixels? There were like a lot of them. They're like you just can't even see them, which is crazy. But I think it's partly because of the checkerboard pattern. Like it's you can't really discern them, and like even when they're staying still, you can't really see them very well. It's like when they slide around that. All right. Again, like it really probably doesn't matter that much, but like we shouldn't bother spending time rendering them, I guess. Like I don't know. There's probably a valid reason why I'm getting rid of them, despite apart from the fact that I just don't like them. There's probably also a good reason. Whoops, wrong layer. Legs layer 4 or layer 14. Yeah, there we go. And then squish. Squish goes the layers, and then this is the new legs layer 2A. Legs 2A, 2A. Do do do. So legs layer 3. Almost there. Yeah, these are the ones that. Oh yeah, do save the image. These are the ones that I need to check. Will work with the upper layers. I need, and it'll probably need to tweak the upper layers a little bit to get them to work because I don't think they will initially. I had to tweak the other layers or the other like I need to tweak the yellow version. So like right because if I show legs one, which are the corresponding pair, yeah they. I mean I guess this is pretty fine, but like I don't know. I was just thinking like. Like they overlap a little bit here, so I was just thinking I would like chip away a little bit there, just to get them to be more slightly more visible. Actually, no, that doesn't even make sense. I mean, they should be like the line should make sense with like the upper leg, because like that would actually be a little bit behind. So that's actually fine and how it should be. Okay, I just wanted to check. And then okay, so then for layer 14, let's use the lasso tool. To scoop up these and bop them on the head, and then squish these together. And this is the new legs layer 3. Ta-da! sorry. So 3A. All right, we can close this one. Last and least. Oh, that's fun. It used to be the tradition that the last leg layer was also the least leg layer, and that tradition remains intact. The last leg layer is still the least leg layer. There's just a little bitty, little tiny leg in the background. Do to do. So get rid of all the sandal business going on underneath there. Secret sandal business. Show legs. You know, it's funny, the way these line up, I actually kind of want to add a touch to this here. I kind of want to, I think it would actually like be a little more visible over this way. But then I think I accidentally drew on top of what should be like darkened. Yeah, like that kind of. I think that, I wasn't necessarily expecting that to be what needed to change, but I think that needed to change, so. And now it's changed. And good. And great. And fantastic. Just top notch. Really, really outstanding. Entirely satisfactory. Okay, that's good. And then, yeah, so. I don't need that one to be visible. I can just smush these together. And this is the new legs layer 3A. Legs 3A. Hey! Alright, one more safety save, and then let's export. Let's to export. And I think this will be 6161. I think. Because, like, the reason the other ones were not 6161 is because of the sandals. But I think this one. I think this little pixel right here. Whoops. I think this little pixel right here on the edge is gonna. Oops. Ugh, wrong tools. Why am I so bad at selecting like this? Okay. I think this little pixel here on the edge is gonna be what makes it 6161. Instead of 6261. Oops. I have one too many pixels on the top. And one too many pixels on the side. Yikes. And 6161. Alright, cool. So we can do data first, as usual, so as not to forget about the data. Projects, journey, equipment, legs, sorry, I was just thinking. What is it? This is farmer pants. sorry. The name farmer pants. Art test. I like leave landmines in my own projects. I like leave little nuggets of like ridiculous that I like. Like if I had any self-respect as a developer, I would not be naming these things as such. And yet I. And so like sometimes I trick myself into thinking I might be a self-respecting dev. And then I stumble across them. Things like farmer pants. And it's like. No. 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 I should not be allowed to name things. All right, so yeah, the layers are all squished together, so copy, new, okay, paste, save. This one, let's put it in the correct folder. And farmer pants, 0. Alright, it is wonderful as ever to have you, Yakmus. I hope to see you again sometime. copy, new, okay, paste, save, 0A, and legs 1, copy. I'm gonna miss this when we're done. No, I'm not. No, I'm not. But it occurred to me that that would be funny to say. I don't know. I mean, I'll have plenty more of this to do in the future, actually. So, even if I did like miss it, I wouldn't have to miss it for long because this is like the new. This is like a new part of the character art production process. So, now whenever I make new character art, I'll be doing this stuff. So then there's also the fact that I'm not done yet. I still need to do three or four more sets of legs. I think three more sets of legs after this one. Three more sets of legs after this one. I mean, a lot of them are really simple, but or like one of them is really simple, so it's basically like two more sets, but still. So this is two, assume. Yeah, and then I still have to do the mask, the jacket, the mask, the jacket, the banner, and the fox, the owl, and the turtle. So even if I miss this, once I'm done with the legs, I'll still have plenty more to do. Excuse me. That is beautiful imagery, Protoss. Excuse me. That is just marvelous. whoops, I forgot to paste. So marvelous, I forgot to paste. okay. okay, I the next armor set is really similar to this one because all we do is we add a buckle to the shoe. This literally it's just wait, what's it called though? Is it called like shoe buckle? Yeah, shoe buckle. It's literally just the exact same thing, except it's you can't even see it like in the small view. It looks like basically identical. Oh, and it's only on one foot, right? It's only on the outside foot, so it's just this shoe buckle. So yeah, we only need to edit. Yeah. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy Farmer Pants art test. Whoops, I don't want to put it in another folder. I want to copy it here. So the new one is going to be shoe buckle art test. And I mean, it's not as much of a test at this point. Like, we're pretty certain that this is going to be the new art system at this point. Edna, say, how's it going? Welcome. We did more pants. If you guessed pants, you guessed correctly. Yeah, okay, so we have this shoe buckle that we're gonna slap on places, and yeah, right, like, so because we're so, like, because we made it through, like, well, I don't know what, like, I was expecting to go wrong. So I guess it's entirely possible that something will still go wrong, but, like, at this point, like, I'm less expecting that something will go wrong. At this point, it seems more likely that actually things will work out great. So, I don't know. I guess I'm tentatively optimistic at this point. And so let's finish this off by slamming this shoe buckle into place. I think we don't need to. Yeah, like it's like the, so the shoe buckle is on the outside of the foot. So like we actually only need to show it in one of the layers. So or like in on some of the feet. So for example, it goes on this foot. Actually, I might as well see if I can use the buckle again. No, it's gonna be in like no, it's gonna be at different angles, and so it's not gonna. I'm not gonna be able to use the same buckle. For both of the. I'm not gonna be able to use the same buckle. Like I can't just like copy and paste it between these slides. But at least not for all of the instances. But actually for some of them I guess I can, because here it's vertical. Vertical works the same as like horizontal, so actually maybe I can. because it's just like this buckle here. So copy oops. I don't like how the lasso tool like does diagonals sometimes. I wish it would just like stay orthogonal. Because I don't know what the diagonals mean all the time. And so, whoops. Yeah, whatever. This is fine. Okay. So copy this. Okay. So legs. What is this? Layer 0. Doop-a-doop. So it's basically just a buckle that goes like on the side of the shoe. Shoe buckle. Shoe buckle. Shoe buckle. It's like that, basically, right? Yeah. Okay, and then so sure. And then so I know what 0A is gonna look like. It's gonna look like that. So let's go to legs 1 now. So 1 corresponds with 3. So I wonder if this no, I might need to redraw the shoe buckle. Actually, no, that kind of fits. well, That doesn't fit exactly. Hold on, let's make a new layer for it. Because I might be able to make it fit. What is it that I want to do? I want to basically mirror it. Flip vertical, flip horizontal. No, that's not what I meant to do. What is it that I'm trying to do? I'm just trying to, like, flip it vertical, and then rotate it. Yeah. Rotate 90 degrees. Whoops. Nope, not the whole image. Just the layer. Rotate the layer 90 degrees. What? Why did it get all blurry? You're not supposed to get blurry, you weirdo. Why'd you get blurry? Fine, whatever. You can flip the whole... You can rotate the whole image just fine, but you can't rotate, like, a single frame. So fine, I'll just put it in a new image, and we'll rotate it like that. So flip vertical, rotate 90 degrees. Yeah. Crazy. Fine, get rid of that buckle. I don't want your buckle. and then, oh wait, why is there that white pixel in the corner? Where the heck did that white pixel come from? Weird. sorry, I was just catching up on chat. Oh wait. Sorry, Edvinus asked, remember when I said I will finish today? I don't think I said I'll finish today. I said there's a chance I'll finish today. If you mean finish this, if you mean finish this whole, shebang, like the legs and stuff, I don't, I think at one point I was, like, tentatively optimistic that I might finish today. I don't think I ever said I was going to finish today, because that would have been quite a bold claim. Not that I'm not bold sometimes, just that would have been a bolder claim than I'm typically prone to make. That's kind of the right position for the buckle. Yeah. So that's pretty good. Maybe I don't have to redraw the buckle. I can just keep pasting it on various places. Actually, the last one might prove me wrong. Because what is the last one? The last one is, legs 1.A, or one, not 1.A, but 1A. Oh, oops, I didn't smush those layers together. Oops. What was that? It was legs 3 and layer 14. Squish those together. Yeah. And then, so yeah, so... Oh no, this is going to work out great, because this one I can just borrow from here. Perfect. Perfect. Alright, so... Blam-a-slam. Oops, wrong layer. perfect. Now perfect. So, I guess it goes there? No, it goes a little further to the toe. Yeah, I guess there is a better position for it. Yeah, I guess that's fine. Okay, and then, yeah, and so then in the last one, oh yeah, so... Let's paste, expand canvas, edit. So image, image rotate 90 degrees, and then copy. Because yeah, because the last one is flat-footed. The last one is legs 1. No, legs 0A and. Legs 2. No, 2A. Yeah. I have an extra leg showing. Yeah, so the last one is this one. Oh, oops, I have to use a new layer for this, because I need to flip it. I have to flip it vertical. Nope. Wait, where'd it go? Not vertical. Sorry, horizontal. Layer flip horizontal. Yeah. Oops. All right, I need it to be... Oh, whoops, I'm rotating. I did not mean to rotate. I need it to be above this layer, because it needs to sit on top of this layer. Like so. Shiny buckle! Shiny buckle! Shiny, shiny buckle! Should it go here or here? I think maybe here. I know... Well, I won't, like, lock that in yet, but, like... What was it? So for legs, like, 3... Yeah, 3A... Yeah, I think this is good. Okay. So I'll squish these layers together, and then, yeah, so, for this, we just, like, most of these will actually be the same. The only ones that actually change are, 0, 2, 0, 0A... 3 and 3A, because these all represent the same foot. So let's open these ones for editation. We can close these other files that we don't need. Don't save. And then, yeah, so we can take extents as per usual. And yeah, so take extents as per usual, and then we only have to export those four specific layers into their awaiting files. Zero, copy. Oh wait, these got opened in the weird order. It goes zero. This is three. Okay, so zero. This is zero. So paste, save. Okay. 0A, copy, paste, save, okay, layer 3, copy, paste, save, okay, excuse me, and layer 3A, copy, paste, save, okay, alright, so that one was quick. So tall boots is going to be like a new thing. So basically, like, not literally start from scratch, but like we can get rid of everything that we have here for tall boots. Oops, wrong button. Delete, not backspace. We can just get rid of all the legs because we will start. We're not going to literally start from scratch, but we will start from a different set of assets. And so we might as well just clear out the ones that we have here. To make room for the new ones. The time is 5:27, and I've been streaming for 7 hours and 15 minutes or thereabouts. It says right on my thing, 7 hours and 18 minutes. I forgot I had that right on screen. sorry. sorry. I was just catching up on chat. Hey, Sims 1880, how's it going? Welcome. so the cookie story. I skimmed it too fast earlier, and I didn't get all the nuance and the intricate plot development. excuse me. okay, what am I doing? Let's import the white pants. So let's. hey, that's the new follower, nice. Sims 1880, welcome to the channel. Thank you very much for following. the visual visual target for our next visual target. The next one is tall boots, which they're pretty plain. They just like it's just white pants with a belt and boots that go up to the knee, and just like a little stripe across the boot. Like that's all there is to it. It's a very simple look. But it's not really like anything that we've done before. So the closest that we can start with is the white pants. So let's go with the white pants art test. Open these, and the shoe is gray, right? The shoe with the white pant is gray. So one thing that we'll want to do is like darken the shoe to get it in. Actually, yeah. So I'm gonna open up some of the tall boot images, like these items here, and so that way we can well, I guess I can import first. So yeah. So let's import. I'm going to assume that it's 6161, but if it doesn't look right at 6161, I'll double check. No, it does look right at 6161. I mean, again, like I think I was just like a little fast and loose with like the edge here, because like the edge gets like covered up by the hand, so like you don't actually really see that connection piece, and like I could have rendered that better, but yeah. Other than that, I think this is actually the correct alignment. And if it's not, it's the new correct alignment. So yeah. Okay. So 0A goes on 6161, as do they all. Oops, new layer. Or different layer. Paste this as layer one. Hey, that is also the new follower noise. Because the new follower noise has not changed since the last time that was the new follower noise. Cheeseman Panda, hey, welcome to the channel. Thank you. Oh, right, yeah, okay. S instead of Z. welcome. I like that your alternate name is the one where it's spelled correctly. I like that you turn conventions on your head. You are a free thinker. So 6161, 61 s'more. Why did I say that? I've been having that reaction to the things that I say surprisingly often. I might want to do something about that. Oh, wait, did I not? I must not have hit copy. Oh, wait, no, this file is literally open twice. Why is this file literally open twice? That's distracting. Or no, are they just like in the wrong order or something? No, that one was literally open twice. Why was that one literally open twice? Oh, whoa. Is one of the files like, wait, what? What is happening here? Oh, no, I pasted. Okay, I pasted here instead of copying from here. Yeah, I was like, why, what? Okay. Yeah, so no legs layer two, there we go. That's correct. So oh, smudgy pixels. I sense smudgy pixels. No? Maybe I might have hallucinated those ones. Yeah, it's not that bad. I think what I was responding to was like this weird like notch in the leg that doesn't have to be there, but no. Alright, this is fine. Do do do. There we go. And then so that was layer two. Don't save. Select all, copy, not paste. And then on layer 2A, paste. And 61, 61. Do do do. And then select all, copy. Layer 3, paste. And do do do. So when I edit the colors of the shoe, I won't have to worry about seams, because like I can like mess up the ankle of these layers that I'm importing as much as I want, because I basically have to do two separate treatments to get oh hey, Ceiling Fairy, how's it going? Welcome. I basically have to do two separate treatments to get the boot to the right boot color and to get the pant to the right pant color. So because the boots like come up over the shin in the new look, the tall boots do, whereas the old boots don't. I have that leeway, like that middle section I have to redraw anyways, so I can kind of like trash it when I'm making the conversion. That, as you may have guessed, was the new follower noise. Blue Cheese Man Panda. Thank you for following and welcome to the channel. Is that how blue cheese is spelled? I thought it was spelled the other way. Like blue cheese, yeah. So maybe, oh no, I guess it's spelled, no, I guess it is spelled correctly. Blue or blue. Bleh. 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 Huh. All right. Nope. I was wrong. Blue cheese apparently was the original, according to the internet. Interesting. All right. I don't care about the whole thing, though. I don't. I wasn't that interested in the topic. Yeah. So yeah. According to that, like that article that I didn't read all of, it was saying that like that it probably that it may have originated from France, but that the original usage was the full conversion of like blue, the word blue. Yeah, I don't know. Okay. Let's do what with this? Yeah, so okay, we don't need to be looking at like all eight legs at the same time. So let's hide most of them. And then yeah, so the one of the so there'll be two orders of business. The first one here, I'm just gonna basically like grab a big chunk of this image and put it in the other image here, because I want to line up. I want to basically convert the two. So like for starters, I can just yeah, let's see if I can get the brightness and contrast of these to line up. Actually, yeah, let's move this over here, and then let's see if we can get the brightness and contrast of the shoe to line up with like the what we want the boot to be. So let's select the correct layer and then adjust brightness contrast. So we want, hey, that I actually don't know what that noise is. No, that's the that is the new follower noise. Finri cheese joins the party. Yeah. Fair warning, I usually just ban people that have the name Binry in their name. Just, I'm not saying I intend to ban that account of yours. I just like, I'm trying to think of a situation where someone made a name referencing my name and they didn't end up banned, and I can't remember it. It's not that there's literally a rule that your name can't contain my name. It's just that I think people who tend to go down that path tend to go far down that path, and they tend to cross lines, and they tend to get banned. So just fair warning, heads up. All right, I think these tones look pretty close. They might not be exact, but I think they're satisfactory in how close they are. So 0026, 0027, or actually 0127 technically, but whatever. And then this is 0019, and this is 0019. So that's like I'm totally fine with that. Okay, so the other things that I'll need to do are yeah, the color treatment here. So this is 23-15-81. So yeah, what I want to do here is a little different. I want to so 23. Let's crank up the saturation here, and let's add in a new layer. This is incidentally the treatment that I'm about to apply to get these pants to this color is the same treatment I applied once upon a time to get these pants to the color that they are now. So. So let's use the rectangle tool and cover up the pants area that we have here. Let's use the fill rectangle, and let's play with the alpha value of this, because actually I guess we don't even need to do it here. We should just do it in the channel itself. Because if we drop this alpha value down enough, hypothetically, this color should actually be the same as this color. So let's see what it is now. So if we color pick from the image, this now reads as 24-12-84, whereas this is what 23-15-81. So it's very close. We just need So yeah, so how do I get that there? A little more trans, a little more opacity, a little more opaque. A little bit more opaque, I think, will help. So let's layer 14. It's right now it's at 34. So let's click it up to like 36 and see what that does. So now it's 21, 13, 84. Did that get closer? Yeah, that did get closer. All right, so let's click it up a little bit more. So let's click it up to like 40. Let's click it up to 40. Hey! If anyone can guess what that noise is, you're probably really smart. The Awesome Gaming! Welcome to the channel. Thank you very much for following. It was the follow noise. If you guessed the follow noise, you're correct. All right, you got level 51. Congratulations, Lauren. I was looking for that earlier. Yeah, you did. You totally did. Wow, you must have just got that recently because I was looking at it earlier and I was like, he's awful close. No, the reason that it was the reason that I was thinking of it though is the reason I was thinking of it though is that your next level is that you get a special guest star. You unlock the a special guest cameo from a from an unnamed character that I think people already know what is, but I guess not everyone does. So I'll leave it as a surprise for the people who don't know. If you don't know, soon you'll know. All right, so 40 is I guess still slightly too low, so I'm gonna go 42. The other thing that is weird is that like it's like the wrong hue for some reason. Like this one's 21 and this one's like 23, so I might. Other than that, it's basically the same. So I'm gonna say other than that, it's the fine. But like for some reason, it's off by 2 points of hue. So I'm gonna adjust the hue and saturation on this layer to nope, not that. plus two hue. So clicky clicky blammo, and then okay, so 23. I don't know why I got it so exact. Like it doesn't need to be so exact. I could have like it really didn't need to be that exact. But all right, so we need to duplicate this layer like a million times. Because we need to basically like apply it to all these other layers. Oh yeah, except right, so hide the other one. And what kind of cheese do I like? Top tier, mozzarella, ricotta, parmesan. I'm Italian. I don't know if you can tell. and then I like a lot of different cheeses, though. It's hard to go wrong with cheese, right? Like, oh, I guess the one cheese that I probably don't think I'll probably ever try. I mean, who knows? Maybe I'll try it eventually someday in my life. But the thing I don't ever like specifically plan on trying is that there's literally like a cheese that like is like supposed to be like rotten and like inedible in, on purpose. But I guess they don't make it inedible on purpose, but they literally make it like rotten and like infested with like, well, I won't tell you what, but like that's probably enough to like make you think like I probably don't want that, right? Like the word infested in the context of food, you know, I don't know. Like that doesn't, to me, that doesn't scream like delicious, let me try it. It screams something, but not that. all right, cool. So now these pants are like the same color automatically. So that's neat. So now we just have to bring the boot up and put the belt on and yada yada. And we get to go, basically. So I might just reuse the same belt actually, because like the we haven't changed the waist of the character, so hypothetically this belt should still fit. Hypothetically, let's see how it works in practice. So legs 0. So if, oh, I should squish these layers together first, and then yeah, okay, so hypothetically these do fit together, but then the thing is that the leg is different. So yeah, You know, I'm gonna actually do this on a different layer. Oh yeah, so I do still want to merge these together. And then so I'll do a new layer, paste, and have you really tried that cheese? Oh, okay. It's not that bad. I read it's not that bad, and like, really? I mean, I guess that's understandable. Like, the phrase "it's not that bad" kind of like hinges on how bad you expect it to be. So, considering how bad I expect it to be, like, in order for that to be not that bad, it just means that it doesn't literally have to like cause me to like be in a coma for like 10 years, right? As long as it doesn't make me be in a coma for 10 years, it's not as bad as I like hypothetically imagine it to be. Not that I expect it to be like expect me to be in like I don't think it literally would have that effect per se. I just mean like when I think about that and like think about like how great it would be to try that how great it would be to like try that thing. Like I think I put that like about on the same tier as like being put into a coma for for 10 years. Like I find those things those possibilities equally attractive. All right, yeah. So for this it's like I guess like the belt, the old version of the belt isn't like an exact match. But it's like actually I guess the belt can stick out a little bit. I was like shouldn't stick out that much though. I don't know. I think this was like another one of those things that like it took me forever to draw it the first time. I'm just gonna redraw it probably because like it's not gonna look right here. So like ugh. Remember how long it took me to draw the last belt? Remember how long that took? It's kind of sad. All right, so. Right, I'll just do it like that, I guess, and then stop touching it. Oh, but actually, before I do that, oh gosh, why does that look so bad? I don't know why it looks so bad. Maybe it'll look great once I put in the, maybe it'll look super great once I put in the boot, like the full boot, but like right now, I don't know. I like kind of can't stand how bad it looks. Okay, speaking of the boot, let's do that. So it goes up to about the knee, which I think comes up about here. I think the knee is about at this height. And then, I don't know why I'm using such a small brush still. I really, like if I don't need to be using such a small brush, I really shouldn't just be in the habit of it, because it's a really bad habit to be in. Alright, yeah, so the boot comes up about to there, and then there is a... Right, so here's an example where I do need to use a fine band, which is to put in the band around the boot. Yeah, so it's basically like this, except this looks more like a galosh. Wait, is the singular of galoshes a galosh? If I think these boots look like galoshes, do I think one of them looks like a galosh? Is that... I don't know if that's how that works. Sorry, I was just scrolling up in chat and reminiscing about the times the times we talked about cheese. Oh, sorry. The Awesome Gaming. You said you're making your own game right now? That's awesome. Good job. It's double awesome because it's you. Camembert de Normandy? What is a... thank you, Edna. Oh yeah, thank you. Yeah, you're the secret belt weapon, right? You're the thank you, positive programmer. Yeah, all right, thank you, Edvinus. I'm definitely going to need that for when I draw the belt. I think this might be fine, like the belt. I think like this might be fine for the belt. I just it's like this leg. Like, this leg is the difficult one. And then if I can get this to work, then the rest of it'll work fine. Although, I think I was a little bit, like, last time I drew this, I think I was a little bit sloppy with how I had this this coming across here. It's just like, I don't know. I think it was just like it doesn't feel like I was really going for anything. I feel like it was just like poorly rendered. So I'm gonna try and like make that a little less poorly rendered. And then I don't know, I guess that's a little better, maybe. Maybe. I don't know. And then right, so it definitely doesn't work for this layer yet. So I'll have to fix that still. But before I do that, I'm gonna, I guess I'll just duplicate it. Because I'll want to be using it for other layers too. Okay, so oh here, I should name these layers so I don't accidentally delete them or something. So this is like the tint layer, and this is the belt layer. Okay. So yeah, so for this, so what do I need to do for the belt for this layer? I guess I can squish these together and like work with them on the same layer now. Because like basically I just need it so that like this comes up a little higher. And like I guess it can literally like come up a little bit more. Like maybe it just like, yeah, that's fine. That's totally fine. That's all we needed to do. Okay. Thank you, Edvness. That was, it was because of your blessing. See, before your blessing, it took me like, you know, it was harrowing and I couldn't figure it out and it came out bad no matter what I did. You gave your blessing and then blam, just instant success as all you. all right. So oh yeah, I guess those 2 pixels that I just added to the belt layer. I want to do that, I guess, basically every time I use the belt layer. Oh, I don't actually need this this little knee snippet up here in the corner anymore, because we now have our conversion master success Excelsior, whatever. okay, so yeah, let's just go down the list. So that was legs layer 0. Oh, I will want to take you know what, actually I will do legs layer 2 next, because I want to take a screenshot of the well, no, you know what, I said this before and I can just use, yeah, you know what, I'm just gonna actually, I don't know why I didn't just do this earlier. I'm just gonna use this whole thing as like the visual target, and that way I don't have to like click between separate layers. I don't have to like blah blah whatever. I can just like, I'll have this right here as like the visual target as I'm working. And I don't need I don't need like the whole both legs, so I'll just like go like that. So I'll just have the boot right there so that I know what it is that I'm trying to make, and I know what it's supposed to look like. All right, so I'll want to duplicate the tint layer, because I want to apply a tint to this layer, legs layer 2, and actually no, I don't have to do legs layer 2 yet. I can do the other layers first. So legs layer 0A. Let's do this one next. So tint layer, the tint, we don't want it to cover the boot. We only want it to cover this upper part, and we don't want it to get interfered with by these other things. So want to doop-a-doop, just just want to delete that, and then blammo! Look at that, magical tint, automagically tintful. Okay, and then yeah, right. So then for the boot, we want to apply the contrast, the brightness contrast changes, so that way it gets darker, and then we just draw the rest of it together. Oh, and the belt. We want the belt as well. So duplicate this layer, slide it up here, show it, and yeah, this one's gonna be different as well. So actually, you know what? I'm actually not gonna use this belt. I'm gonna use this belt for most of the other ones, but and by most of the other ones, I mean the other two. But actually, for this one, I'm actually gonna borrow from legs layer 0 to get the belt, because like they're both gonna be like the way that this one is different from the others, the legs or the way that legs layer 0 is different from the others, legs layer 0A is gonna be even more different in that way. So yeah, like so like we lifted up the belt a little bit for this one, and so we're gonna lift it up even more for. We lifted up a little bit for the first one. We're gonna lift it up significantly more for this one, because like a lot of it's just gonna be covered up by the leg. So yeah, I think that's probably gonna look okay. Hopefully, maybe. Let's see what it looks like with the chest back in place. All right, so it's not perfect yet, but we can fix it. by like bringing this out, I think. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. Yeah, and then oh yeah. So actually, I guess I might as well. I'm just gonna show the belt again real quick because I do want to. Before I forget, I'm just gonna copy these pixels here to here because I want to do that, and that's good now. Okay. just before I forget. All right, and then so leg 0A are now all. Oh no, I haven't drawn the boot yet. They're doing pretty good though. what am I doing? Okay, yeah, the boot. Das Boot. Which does not mean the boot. I think it means the boat or something. Or like a boat or something. I don't remember. I don't actually speak German. I just like when talking about boots to say Das Boot. I don't know why. Maybe because it annoys smart people. If I just to smart people, that makes no sense. To say Das Boot when talking about a boot. And I think I'm a little bit of a troll at heart, so maybe that's why I say it. Do do do. And then right, so oh yeah, I didn't really do it on the other one, but I guess like I actually do kind of like shade this band. So it's like this band as it goes across, I use like the lighter tone for the lighter side, and I use the deeper tone for the deeper side. Which I don't think I really did that with the first layer. I don't know if it really matters, but yeah, no, I technically didn't, and I guess I could, because, well, no, there's not much of the darker, yeah, there's not much of the darker tone, so it'd only really be, like, here that it'd even be noticeable. Oh, and it's not even, like, oh, because, well, I'm drawing on the wrong layer. I was like, it's not even showing up, it's not even, like, a visible difference, but no, if I draw on the correct layer, it probably will be. yeah, just, like, yeah, I don't know, it's a subtle thing, but whatever. Literally, no one's ever gonna notice, but whatever. Do-do-do. Again, the wrong layer. Always the wrong layer. Always. I was even saying do-do-do as I drew on the wrong layer. If I'd instead sped that spend blah, 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 if I'd instead spent that time. Oh, did I level up again? No. Okay. I had another notification on Twitter. And I'd already leveled up twice today. I was like, wow, really? Have I leveled up again? But no, it was just a regular notification. Oops. I'm like, every time I get a notification, I'm like, it must be trusty Bard telling me about a level. All right. Sorry. Yeah, what is up with stuff? What the what? This one's good now. That is what boots look like, and so forth. So now, yeah, so, right, this needs a lot of work because it needs a new tint layer. So, bring this up here. And, oh, I don't know if this tint layer. Yeah, this will. I was going to say, I don't know if it'll cover everything, but I think this will. I think if we bring it down here, because, like, the rest of this, the boot will cover up, so we only have to really bring it to, like. Yeah, this should be fine. And then, alright, so. We use the Select-A-Majig to select these and delete these and then smoosh these together. And then, so we'll duplicate the. Wait, I said smoosh these together. And then I'll duplicate the belt layer. Duplicate and move this up here and. Really? That's lower than I expected it to be, but whatever. Okay. Get rid of. This darkness, yeah. So on this side, the belt will kind of like do the opposite thing. On this side, the belt will get lifted up more on this side. So the belt like goes up a little bit like that, I guess. And then is that? Oh yeah. And so then also, we don't need this to come up so high. It doesn't need to come up above the belt line. Is that right? Is that like, the belt seems a little bit low set. Is that? Is that normal, or did it get like offset by a pixel? Sometimes it does that. Sometimes, like, when you paste stuff, it, like, doesn't show up at the same place. Oh, yeah, I should, No, that looks the same. I mean, it's, like, shifted a little bit, because, like, on the different legs, it... No, that looks correct, actually. Okay, so, Sure. Oh, yeah, so let's tint the boot correctly. Or, like, shift the boot to be darker as such. Brightness and contrast. Okay, wait, what? Oh, wrong there. As usual. Yep. Legs layer one adjustments, brightness and contrast. Okay. Right, so now, let's just paint this down, then paint this up. Oh yeah, bigger brush. Doop-a-doop, doop-a-doop-a-doop, up to the knee. So the knee, like the legs, actually, like, oh, sorry, I was zoned out of chat. excuse me, sorry. These compliments are getting more elaborate, right? I'm assuming, or like, I don't know, it seems like at this point, eventually they'll come in the form of like a short story. I am eternally impressed. I'm still in awe of what you're coming up with. I don't even know what to say. thank you. I guess thank you. I never necessarily expected to be saying thank you for your for comparing my troll heart to a majestic ruby, but I know, I guess I never really anticipated that situation to come up. So thank you. Sorry, excuse me. I have like the dry giggles. It's like, excuse me. Sorry. Oh yeah, did I tell you guys that I'm like a 12-year-old, and I got a bike, which was exciting to me. I mean, I guess not like not only 12-year-olds get bikes, but I felt like a 12-year-old this week because I've been really excited about how I got a bike. I don't know what reminded me of that. I guess like. I was because I actually I'm probably gonna when I'm done streaming I have to I'm gonna go take my shiny new bike for a spin, and I'm not gonna stop streaming now necessarily. I think I'll probably actually try and finish up all the legs tonight, but it just occurred it's you know it's later in the evening, so it was occurring to me that I probably will do that at some point. I'm gonna do it on my shiny new bike. Shiny new bike. It's not actually new, it's like pre-owned, but like it's like last year's model and like it looks great, so I don't know what the previous owner did, but like they like didn't ride it or something. They like forgot to ride it or something. I don't know. actually Ruby's my birthstone, so it would make sense that my majestic troll heart is a ruby. maybe you sense that. Maybe it shows in my personality. The trollish side of my personality. all right, so this is good, I think. Oh, I might like the knees again. Like anything that comes up to the knee, like on the layers, legs layer 3 and 3A. Like it's the sort of thing that it might get. I might have to come back and revisit this layer, like if this layer interferes with the other layer. But all right, so let's duplicate tint layer. Bring this up here to this layer, and then yeah, this one's gonna be a little bit weird. I just need to. Oops, no, not that tool. I just need to slide this over, and then oh, it doesn't actually fit. So let's duplicate this layer again and slide the other one over to here. I'll smoosh these layers together first and then oh, whoops. Oh, weird. I can't smoosh these layers together. I have to shoot them separately. All right, that's fine. All right, so then let's lasso this and hide the chest layer and also lasso this and this, and that should be fine. And we need to delete this from both layers then. Well, I guess I have to do it twice. Okay. And delete from this layer as well. Yeah, okay. And then also, I'll not want to cover up so much of the boot. So I'll probably want to just like do something like this as well. From that layer, and then also from this layer. And then yeah, so to merge these layers together, I need to merge first, I need to merge this lower layer to the image, and then I need to merge this upper layer. Because as we saw before, because each of those layers had like a different opacity, or like both of those layers were at lower than full opacity, when I merged them together, the low opacity of one of them, I mean, I guess I could have just undid the opacity on one of them. Or there's a number of ways I could have done that, but what happened when I just tried to merge them together is that it multiplied the opacity. It was like more opacity than before even. Okay, so here, yeah, once again, really, is that the positioning of this belt? Yikes. Yeah, I guess actually, like before, I instead of using this belt clone, I'm going to use the belt from the previous layer as the starting point instead, because it's not going to be exact. Neither are exact, but this is actually going to be the better starting point, I guess. So copy from this layer, and then paste onto this layer. Yeah, so this will be like the starting point, and then but like as we see here, like the leg actually comes up a little bit higher, so it's gonna be more like this actually. Maybe not quite that high. But let's see how that looks. Yeah, that's a little too high. but all right, let's show the chest and just for like to see it in context, and then yeah, so I guess it'll basically like come. Oops, wrong layer. It'll basically come up like this. Maybe not even that high. Maybe just like that. No, that looks weird. It looks like the belt looks too low. Yeah, so maybe it would come further back. Maybe it would come further back like this, and then the belt would actually be like lifted a little bit up, a little bit or something. It would actually like track a little bit higher. I don't know if that's quite right, but it's probably fine enough. It's probably fine enough, I guess. Yeah. Actually, oh, the one thing I will do though is I'll like if it's tracking higher, it should at least follow the curve of the leg, so it should come up a little higher, a little faster, and yeah, I don't know. Like that. I don't know, that looks weird too. But whatever. I think it also probably looks fine. Okay. So yeah, let's do the boot. The boot. The boot. do to do. So yeah, let's do adjustments, brightness and contrast, blammo, deselect. Is this really the shape of the boot? I don't know. I mean, I guess so. But oops, looks a little thick, but maybe that's how it's supposed to be, I guess. I don't know. Okay, no, stop. Stop! What? Oh, my fingers are on the wrong hotkeys. I was like, why is it not switching to the brush key? Or the brush tool? And it's because I was pressing V, not B. Doop doop. So, yeah, again, up to the knee. Doop doop doop. How did I do this with the other leg? I feel like I might have not done it right. I don't know, I just have this like sneaking suspicion that like I made it too low. Did I make it too low? No, I guess that's fine. Yeah. Because like I remembered, I was like trying to angle it like this so that it's kind of like flat on the top. But I was just thinking like if I did that here, that might make it too low. But no, I guess it like I guess it still works out. Okay. I'll just have to make sure it's like fully rendered up to the top. Yeah, that's probably fine. Okay, and then yeah, like as usual, there is a there comes a point in every shoe's midsection where a little band goes across it, right here, just for this specific shoe.